We are going to be now welcoming to the show Gary Saperstein, who's the owner of Out in the Vineyard. This is an event that Tim and I went to 2 years ago, maybe?
Probably, yeah.
Before the fire is out in the valleys. And it's an amazing event. I urge you to check it out. So, Gary, are you with us?
I am. How are you?
All right, sir. First and foremost, this used to be called Gay Wine Weekend, but it's now broadly Out in the Vineyard. And mm-hmm. there's also a lot of new things that you've added here. So why don't you give us a little synopsis of what you're up to?
Yeah, I'm excited. This year is going to be an amazing year. I've wanted to grow the event for some time now, and so I'm sort of growing up, I guess you can say. And what it really does is it's going to give everybody a chance to really experience, you know, a little bit more of wine country than they normally do, since it's going to be extended for 4 more days. So I'm thrilled about that. But of course, the weekend, and you guys were here and got to experience it, you know, but it was almost 5 years ago now, right?
Is that how long? John thought it was 2. Must be 5.
No, oh my God, no. Time goes fast. Time goes so fast.
It does.
But yeah, it was something, it's almost like 5 years now, maybe 4.
Wow.
But, it's going to really be a full week of events where the weekend will pretty much stay, you know, what we did beforehand. You know, we'll have the Twilight Tea Dances, the signature event of the weekend. We still have the brunch now as something new, though. You got to attend the Sunday brunch, but that's now a Sunday. It's a drag queen brunch. Yes, which was the first time we did it last year. It still is a benefit for Face to Face, which is our Sonoma County HIV/AIDS network. And I'm just thrilled because we've really been able to raise almost $400,000 over the course of the last decade for the organization. And then this year, you know, still we have the winemaker dinners, the winery tours will still take place. And then during the weekday, it really will give people more of an opportunity to even experience more of the region. And one thing I'm really excited about is that we will, on Tuesday, Jim Obergefell, who is the lead plaintiff in the marriage equality case, is going to lead a tour of Russian River, some Russian River wineries, starting at one winery that he's a co-owner of called Equality Vines. So that's going to be really fun. Then we're going to do an all-gay winemaker dinner one of the evenings as well. So that should be, of course, is going to be a ton of fun. And it just really is going to give everybody more of an opportunity, as I said, to sort of experience a little bit more of the region by staying over during the weekdays as well.
So this is in a beautiful part of the country, of course, in Sonoma, and right, what, about an hour outside of San Francisco?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
This year it's July 16th through July 22nd, and it really is, I believe, one of the premier, I said on Facebook, it really is the LGBTQ event of events. I mean, it really is a great event, and you bring people in from all over the country. How many people do you expect are going to attend this year?
Yeah, I'm expecting approximately 700 people come into Sonoma for the course of the week, and from all over the country. Previous years, it's been about 18 different states people have been coming from that are represented here for the weekend.
So the big event that's at the Chateau, is this Chateau Saint-Jean?
Yeah.
Chateau Saint-Jean.
So that was a much bigger event, right? People come in from San Francisco for that, for the evening, right?
Twilight
Tea. Oh, absolutely. We get a lot of that. That event's the largest event because it is the largest space where it can accommodate that many people. So approximately 700 people will attend that one event. And it's in, the setting is absolutely stunning. First of all, Chateau Saint-Jean is a huge supporter of our LGBTQ community for the past. This will be their 5th year hosting the Twilight Tea Dance. And I mean, the setting is stunning. Rolling hills and vineyards all around you. And the sun is setting as the moon is rising. And you can't beat it. It's just absolutely a stunning setting with a DJ and a disco ball, of course.
So a lot of people might not be aware, because of all the coverage that was given to the fires, the terrible fires out in the valleys. How is wine country faring after that?
You know, we're doing good. We are, I like to say, we're open for business. It still is absolutely beautiful. Even though it definitely both what happened in 2017 and what happened this past year were awful events. So many people who lost their homes, businesses had to be closed for a certain amount of time. So we're on the way back, though. We're in recovery mode. And what we need more than anything is really for people to come back and visit. And that's why the word is just, you know, we're open for business. Come and you will enjoy wine country. Fortunately, if you want to say fortunately, most people, when you come to wine country, you're not even going to see the areas that did burn.
Wow. Hey, I have a question that's more of a business question. So the press out here in the last week seems to keep saying that California wines are going to be at a discount because there's such a surplus of grapes. Is that true?
Yeah. I mean, I know I've been reading the same articles over the course of the past like week as well. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens. There has been it's been each year for the past few years, we have seen, you know, wine production has been up. And it seems that consumer buying and or drinking is down a little. So I guess we could see where that could be, what could happen, which could mean that prices could go down a little bit on wine, which could be a good thing in the long run.
Right.
I noticed you also added something that we did not experience, but I happen to like rosés myself. But there's a new event, and it's the Pink Sonoma Saturday. And this is a wine tasting revolving around rosé, which I think is really great, especially since this is happening in the summer. And I always associate rosé with a definite summer vibe, right?
Right, no doubt about it. And it's perfect. This event, I did it for the first time last year in the beginning of May. This year, it'll take place May 2nd as well. And it's a benefit for Positive Images, which actually supports LGBTQ youth here in Sonoma County. And it's a great opportunity to really try and find your summer rosé wines to drink while, you know, poolside or on the patio or on the porch, wherever you may be. And it was truly such a fun event last year. I call it was quite colorful because not that it's mandatory, but a lot of people did wear pink. So it was a fun evening and quite colorful. If you go on the website, and look at the gallery of pictures, you'll see how colorful the day was, and really looking forward to doing it again.
And that's just a one-day event
in May 2nd.
It's a one-day event, May 2nd. It takes place. Our presenting sponsor is Vianza Winery, which is a beautiful winery. One of the first you come as you enter into Sonoma, up in the hillside overlooking the summit of Sonoma Valley. So stunning views, and it should be hopefully another beautiful day.
Now, something we talk a lot about on the show is the sometimes a lack of support for LGBTQ media or events. And you've done a nice job of getting some marquee sponsors. Have you found it difficult to try to find sponsorship to help support the event, or is it just because you guys have had such success that it's a little easier?
You know, I'd never say it's easy because I never just count that it's going to come that so easily to you. I'm real fortunate here in wine country. The support of the wineries and donating wine for all the events over the course of the weekend, for the wine tours and winemaker dinners and at the tea dances is phenomenal. But, you know, when you're talking cash sponsorships, those are a little bit, you know, more challenging to come by. But I feel really fortunate this year. Really excited that American Airlines has come on as a major sponsor, the official airline of Gay Wine Week. Virgin Voyages is coming on as a sponsor. They're going to sponsor the pool party, so you can imagine how fun that should be. And we're looking forward to that as well. But always looking for new sponsors, and it's sort of fun to meet people. And what it's all about, with, for me, it's about creating a relationship with people that they want to come back and be a part of the event year after year.
The other great thing is that when we attended, it's there's a nice group of people, and it's
a great group.
It's a diverse group of people, and obviously men, women, gay, straight, everybody's welcome. Yeah. So it's
open to all.
We really could not say enough nice things about the event, and when we were out there, and
to come back again.
We do need to come back.
We had good weather, and on that trip we also went to Jelly Belly.
That's right.
That we had a tour of the Jelly Belly factory, which was south of where a lot of these festivities are taking place. All right, so July 16th to July 22 is Out in the Vineyard, the Gay Wine Week. If you want to take part in the Pink Sonoma Saturday, which sounds super fun because I'm a rosé fan, that's going to be on May 2nd this year. And just to recap some things that you might have mentioned, there's going to be a winemaker dinner that features an all plant-based dinner, and that's going to be at the Animal Sanctuary. And that's
Absolutely.
Part of the...
That's something new this year also. Plant-based diets are really in right now and really making a lot of headway in this country. So I thought it was time, being on the cutting edge a little bit, or maybe it's not even on the cutting edge a little bit at this point, but I'm really excited to be able to offer an all plant-based winemaker dinner with a wine that is 100% vegan as well.
That's really cool, right? Just to be exposed to some of this stuff is fantastic. The host hotel is the Lodge at Sonoma.
Yes.
And it's just 5 blocks from the town square. It's a beautiful place, by the way. I think the pool party is probably there too, right?
No, the pool party now is actually at a private estate. I can't give the address away. But it's absolutely a lot of fun. And it's only just a few minutes from the host hotel in a beautiful location. So it makes you feel like a real VIP, like you're living like a local when you're at the pool party.
I like this. And this fact that it's sponsored by Virgin Voyages, which we've been seeing their TV ads. This is the all adult cruises. No kids.
No kids. Exactly.
Yeah, you haven't seen this?
No.
Oh, I looked at it and I thought, oh my God, this is going to be successful. No kids. Yeah.
Yeah, they're just getting ready to launch. And actually, I was just invited actually to join them on their maiden voyage next month before do their first cruise in April. So we're going to test it out, because you'll be the first to know here in April of 2021. Out in the Vineyard is actually going to do a Virgin Voyage cruise.
Wow.
There you go. That's a smart idea. Very smart.
Well, Gary, thanks for joining us. And for our listeners, be sure to go to outinthevineyard.com. You can still order tickets there and get your lodging.
Yes.
And if you can't do the whole week because of schedule, though, you can still do a la carte and pick certain days, correct?
Absolutely. You can do all access VIP pass, or this weekend, actually, all the a la carte tickets will go on sale just for the tea dance and their tours.
Great. Well, thanks for joining us, and congratulations again. And
we can't say enough
great things about it, and we hope to join you again out there soon.
Thank you, Gary.
It's great to see you guys again.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks, Gary.
Take care.
We have to make our way out to Gay Wine Weekend again.
No, it was fun.
We had a lot of it. It was a good trip, yeah.